Hello guys, my name is Alejandro Muñoz. I am from Tafal Madrid, and in this video we are going to talk about some vocabulary in English that maybe we don't know, or it's a little bit tricky because we haven't heard it never. Okay guys, so we are gonna start with 10 verbs, and the first one is to walk on tiptoes. So walk on tiptoe is to walk, but with the front part, with the fingers of our feet, so that way you don't make any noise. So for example, I walk on tiptoes when I come early on night, so that way my mother or my family don't hear me. Perfect. So the second verb is to leap over. Leap over is to jump over something. For example, I leap over that obstacle. So I jump over that obstacle. The third verb is to head. Head, we all know the meaning, so it's the head. But when you use it like a verb, is to head, for example in soccer, to head a ball, to kick the ball with the head. Okay, so the fourth verb is to kick off. Kick off is start, for example, start a match. So kick off a match is like the action to kick the ball and start the match. So that is kick off. The fifth verb is to throw in. Throwing is very similar to the throwing verb, and it's used in tennis matches. So the action to serve, the first serve is to throw in. And that way you start a tennis match in this case. Okay, the sixth verb is stay still. Stay still is to not move. So you stay still. Oh, that is an easy one. So we are jumping to a seventh verb. Overcome. That is to try to be better at something. Or to have in mind, you have to be better at something. You want to be better. So I want to overcome at soccer, at playing soccer, for example. Okay, so the eighth verb is to hop. When you hop, you jump, but only with one leg. So that is to hop. Ninth verb is jog. Jog is to run, but at low pace. So you are jogging. You run, but in a slow rhythm. And the last one is to draw. When you draw at a match, is for example in a soccer match, when you finish with the same goals, the two teams finish with the same goals, so 1-1 for example is a draw match. So that are the 10 verbs. Okay guys, so we are going to continue with 10 objects that we use in the gym or in sports in general. Like for example, a battle rope. A battle rope is used in CrossFit or in cross training, and is this large rope that you use to make strength in a training. Perfect. So skipping rope is this rope you use to jump. For example, in boxing training is very common. So a dumbbell is this object you use to lift in the gym and make strength with, for example, in this case, with your biceps, with your arm. And a treadmill is used also in the gym, and is the object you use to run at the gym. So that's a treadmill. And a stopwatch is, for example, in a 100 meter race, you have to know when you start and when you finish. So you measure that time with a stopwatch. Perfect. So, for example, a sword is used in a swim, and is the object, the sword, the object you play with in a swim. And a rink, for example, is the pitch, for example, of hockey. The camp of hockey is a rink hockey, a rink of hockey. Perfect. So safety mattress is using gymnastics and is where you do the jumps, crazy jumps that they do. So when you crash on the floor, for example, you don't hurt any part of your body. Perfect. So for example, a loud hailer is the object that the fans of a team, so they support their team in shouting with the loud hailer. Perfect. And finally, the hurdle. A hurdle is, for example, another time in a 100 meter race, with the obstacles that they put, so that are hurdles. So you have to run, jump the hurdle, and continue running, jump another hurdle, and continue that until you finish the race. Okay, guys, so we are going to finish with 10 words or 10 expressions that are used in general in sport vocabulary. For example, to give a shot. To give a shot is to give a try, maybe to try something. When you try something, some sports in this case. So why don't you try football? Why don't you give a shot to football? That's a way to use it. The next one is never say die. Never say die is never say never, is the same. So I am not trying football. So I am not going to the gym because I don't like it. So well, never say die. Maybe you do it and you like it. Perfect. So the next two ones are very related. That is, keep getting shape and slim down. Okay, so slim down is to burn fat. Say it that way. You slim down, you get in shape. For example, for the bikini operation, you get in shape, you have to get in shape. And you get in shape, slim down. Perfect. So veggies is a way to say vegetables. So instead of saying vegetable, you say veggies. So I love veggies. So I love vegetables. Perfect. Now we are going to talk about two muscles that are a little bit rare in Spanish because it's said in another form. So for example, the calf muscles, that are the muscles that are in the legs, and the hamstring, that are also in the legs, in the back part of the legs, behind the quadriceps. So that are the hamstrings. Perfect. And we're going to finish with three games that are very traditional here in Spain, and we don't know the meaning in English. So for example, the hanky game is the game that there are two teams and a person hanging a hanky. So he says the number one, and the number one of both teams go to catch the hanky. Perfect. And the play tag is the game that one person have to catch the other person's, so he won in this case. That's the play tag. And last one, the hide and seek, is the game that one person have to catch the others, and the others have to hide so the person don't see them. Okay, so that is. Okay, guys, so I hope you enjoyed the video and you learned something. So these are words that are not difficult, but we haven't heard it so much. So, well, I hope you learn it, and well, thank you.